Hi, this is Dr. K from iMedical School, and today I wanted to just talk about the myths of getting into medical school. Let me begin by saying if you have a 4.0 GPA, recommendation letters from Nobel Prize winners, and a perfect MCAT score, this video really is not for you. This video is for those who may have hit a few bumps in the journey to medical school and have questions about applying. So let's start off with the most important myth. A lot of people think they're not smart enough for medical school. Let me dispel this idea right away, as really there are a lot of dumb doctors, and probably more doctors who think they're smart but really aren't. What makes a really good doctor is someone who's able to work very hard. Of course, you need to be able to understand advanced medical topics, but really, hard work is key. So don't psych yourself out of applying to medical school if you think that you're just not smart enough. The next very important mistake pre-med students make is thinking the more extracurriculars they do, the better. This was a mistake that I made for a while. Remember, med schools aren't dumb. They can tell the difference between someone who is just trying to look good and someone who's really passionate about an activity. So this brings me to the most important advice, which is to focus and immerse yourself in a very few activities and really excel at them. Though extracurriculars are important, you need to focus on your grades. Now, some of you may be thinking, my grades are bad. There's no way I'm getting into medical school. Now, when I say bad grades, I don't mean you get a 92% on your organic chemistry test rather than your usual 100%. If your grades are mediocre or poor, make sure to really focus on the MCAT and kill it. Bleed and sweat MCAT questions until you're getting pretty significantly above average scores. The other important thing is to really play to your strengths, both in your personal statement and in your interviews. You should confront that your GPA is not the best, but really address why you are a strong candidate. Point out how these strengths will make you a great doctor and what you've learned from your mistakes in the past. Another common myth is applicants thinking it is pointless to apply to medical school because they're not a traditional applicant. A non-traditional applicant may mean that you worked a couple years after college in a non-healthcare field, or maybe you pursued some other career, but then realized medicine is what you wanted to do. Let me say that medical schools are very accepting of non-traditional applicants. You can actually use your life and work experience as a tool in both your personal statement and interview. For example, let's say you were an economics major and worked in the finance industry for a little bit. You could say that in addition to your love for medicine and helping others, you really want to focus on bringing healthcare costs down. With your financial background as an asset, you can help accomplish that. So, another important point is don't make excuses if you applied but did not get into medical school, so you had to do something else for a little while. Be upfront. Remember to emphasize that though you may not have made it the first time, you continue to persevere and pursue your love of medicine. Finally, this brings me to the fifth and final myth. I hear a lot of people say they have to be an MD or nothing else will suffice. Let me point out there are some great alternatives to being an MD. And remember, the culture or experience of being a doctor is dramatically changing. You really need to sit down and think, are you ready to make the sacrifices to be an MD? This includes spending less time with friends and family, the hospital essentially being your second home, and whether your significant other also understands the sacrifices he or she will need to be making for you to pursue your goal of being a doctor. In addition, if you can't get into an American medical school, consider a foreign medical school. There's some really good medical schools like St. George, and I've heard have excellent quality education. So there are alternatives out there. Another great alternative to actually being an MD is being a DO or Doctor of Osteopathic Medicine. In the past, there was a stigma about DOs, but that stigma has clearly gone. I have DO colleagues who are excellent physicians. Some are better than the MDs that I work with. In addition, consider other healthcare positions such as nurse practitioner. Though I don't have data to back this up, I do believe nurse practitioners make more money than doctors if you count the fewer training years and the excellent work hours they generally hold. Being a physician assistant, I believe, also provides similar benefits to being a nurse practitioner and allows you to play an active role in patient care. Other careers to consider include nursing, respiratory therapist, and becoming a pharmacist. In the end, remember you should pick a field you truly enjoy and be prepared to make the sacrifices that are necessary. I hope our discussion on the myths of applying to medical school helped. Make sure to share this video with your friends on Facebook and Twitter. You can follow us on Twitter at iMedSchool or on Facebook at our Facebook page, iMedicalSchool. Like this video and place your suggestions for future videos or comments down below. Most importantly, subscribe. This is Dr. K from iMedical School, and I'll see you next time.